My dear darling, I'm very glad you have taken the trouble to place on record the more intimate doings of your distinguished regiment, the 20th Hussars, in the Great War. I congratulate you on the result, which I have read with the greatest interest.
A letter written to Captain Darling during the First World War. The Captain Darling. Not this one, made famous, or infamous, in the BBC's hugely popular Blackadder comedy series set against the backdrop of the First World War. In fact, Captain Blackadder, Lieutenant George and Private Baldrick really did go forth in World War I, it's emerged, after their real-life namesakes were discovered. To mark the centenary of the Great War, specialist military genealogy website ForcesWarRecords has traced the real-life counterparts of Captain Blackadder and his wartime colleagues. Forces War Records researchers delve back through 6 million military records to dig up the stories of Captain Robert John Blackadder, Private James Baldrick, Lieutenant Athelstan Key Durrance George, and Captain John Clive Darling. The fictional characters portrayed by Rowan Atkinson, Tony Robinson, Hugh Laurie, and Tim McInerney appear to share a number of similarities with their World War I namesakes. As well as having the same surnames and rank, all of the men also served in the trenches. Writers of the hit BBC comedy were also surprised that their fictional characters really did exist.
We've been speaking to Tim McInerney, who plays Captain Darling in the TV series, and he's been explaining it to us, you know, that these were actually completely fictitious. And he's been equally as amazed as we were that these four characters have turned up in real life.
Even more surprising was that researchers discovered many similarities between the fictional and non-fictional characters.
The biggest similarities in the characters was Lieutenant George's. The TV character, as we know, was a lieutenant, commissioned lieutenant. He was unmarried when he went in, went to Cambridge. He rode for the college. He was a bit of an artist. He joined the Royal Flying Corps, as we saw in that the episode with the 20-minuters, which was one of my favourites, actually. And the real-life Lieutenant George was pretty much the same. The next one is Captain Robert John Blackadder was the one that we found, the namesake to Captain Edmund Blackadder. They were, again, pretty much the same.
Forces War Record researchers spent many hours meticulously piecing together each of the men's military history.
So this is the Tunbridge School Roll of Honour for the Great War, 1914 to 1919. It has a short history of every officer and enlisted soldier who came from this school and served in the Great War. So this page specifically has Lieutenant George's record. The most significant comments we get whenever people send us in materials or ask us for help is that I regret never asking my ancestors when they were alive what they actually did. Record sites like ours give you that initial basis to kind of prompt you to start talking to your living relatives.
Researchers, however, failed to find the final Blackadder character's namesake in the First World War, General Melchett, but their records show that he makes an appearance in the Second World War. For more information, go to the Forces War Records website.